News about our human ancestors always captures people's attention, especially the arguments of what is and what is not. In 1972, a team led by Richard Leaky discovered a skull that was missing a lower jaw. It looked a lot like that of Homo habilis, but was also different in some ways as it was much bigger with a flatter face. So which species does this fossil belong to? It's a hard question to answer, as at the time there was only one good fossil. Initially, researchers said it was a skull of a male Homo habilis, saying the fossils found may simply represent physical variation within the Homo habilis species due to differences based on geography or sex. But other researchers said the differences were too great to be explained by sex, and they gave the skull the name Pithecanthropus rudolfensis because of the place it was found, which is Lake Turkana, which was once known as Lake Rudolph. Pithecanthropus was later dropped and replaced with Homo. Discovery of more fossils that share the same shape and features provided evidence for the existence of Homo rudolfensis as a separate species. This further suggests that Homo rudolfensis is indeed a separate species because the new jaws are much different from the known Homo habilis jaws, and other fossils are characterized by large cranial capacity around 750 cubic centimeters, large cheek teeth, and a long face that is broad across the orbits or the eye sockets and flat the nose. This is where the real difference lies. Homo rudolfensis was originally thought to be Homo habilis until it came to the size of the brain, in which they found that it had an incredibly larger one in comparison to Homo habilis. In addition to a large brain, Homo rudolfensis has very large premolar and molar teeth similar to the Australopiths, which has led some researchers to question its inclusion in the genus Homo. Other features include brow ridges that are smaller and more integrated into the skull. There are no heavy muscle attachments at the top of the skull, and the back teeth are smaller, whereas the front teeth are larger than related hominin species. They are believed to have lived around 1.9 million to 1.8 million years ago. Besides displaying less prognathism, they also had a rounder brain case rather than a bunning brain case. Brain endocasts indicate that the broadcast area, an area of the brain associated with speech, is more clearly developed in Homo rudolfensis than in Australopiths. However, it must be noted that possessing the neurological architecture for speech does not mean that Homo rudolfensis used spoken language. Their physical build, weight, and height are still unknown due to the scarcity of fossils, but from the fossils that have been recovered, scientists estimated a male of this species was approximately 1.6 meters tall, weighing 60 kgs, and a female was estimated to be 1.5 meters average height, weighing 51 kgs. Limited studies have been done on the diet of this species, but the tooth shape and comparisons to other species suggest they ate both plant material and meat. Despite all that has been proved and described though, debate continues as to whether the fossils should be named Homo rudolfensis, Kinianthropus rudolfensis, or Australopithecus rudolfensis, or returned to Homo habilis. Though it is accepted that the two species Homo rudolfensis and Homo habilis coexisted around 2 million years ago, there is still considerable uncertainty as to how to connect these fossils to other remains from the same geological era, how all of them are related to the Australopiths, and which of the Homo skulls shows us the true ancestor to subsequent humans. For this reason, questions are always coming up, like, are Homo rudolfensis and Homo habilis different species, or are they part of a single variable species? Or was one the ancestor of the other? Paleoanthropologists are constantly in the field excavating new areas using groundbreaking technology and continually filling in some of the gaps about our understanding of human evolution. What are your thoughts on this, guys? Let us in by dropping a comment in the comment section down below. Videos on human species, check our channel out and do not forget to support us by liking our videos and subscribing to the channel. Thanks for watching. Till then, this is Halabella and see you soon in our next video.